Yeah, that means good for you to drive back. Toothbrushes. Oh, it's a fly swatter, so that's interesting.
Washed Ashore, Art to Save the Ocean, is an amazing group of statues. We have 35 of them, and they are all made from marine debris plastic. And the Washed Ashore partner that we're working with has done this as an amazing way to sort of connect people with how beautiful it is. And also then when you get closer, you start to realize the impact of plastics on the ocean.
So recycling is if you use a plastic bottle, let's say, you don't put it in the garbage, you put it in the recycling.
Yes,
also.
The sculpture we have here is Chompers the Shark. Chompers is about 6 feet tall and 10 feet long. He's an amazing example of an incredible ocean animal. And then right here is our Ocean Wonder Shark exhibit where you can go and see real sharks. And it's that combination of the sculpture to really inspire and move you, and then going and seeing the real animals to help make this connection.
There's a Philadelphia cream cheese top.
There's bottle caps. So what they do is they collect the garbage, they wash it.
So out here in Coos Bay, we have a speedway, and instead of those tires, they just throw them into the landfill. I take those, and because racing tires don't have steel in them, they're more of a nylon cord, I can actually cut them with a razor blade. And I use those as my base plastic. So I wire those to the frame, and then from there, I can screw the actual marine debris plastic into the tires.
Oh my God, look, they're two just right there. Okay. They're on a shape.
People are really fascinated. They're horrified. It's the best thing to do.
One second. Oh,
yeah. Bring a bag, gloves on, everything.
And the fine little details, like in a face, I'll use like lighters or combs or, you know, what we call recognizable, so that people see these little items that they use every day. Toothbrushes, shotgun wads, chewing tobacco cans. These are things we see a lot of. And then we attach those at the very end. So it's more powerful when someone walks up and is like, oh, I use these things. Maybe I could try to use something that's reusable.
Oh wow, there's a pufferfish.
And the fins are all made of plastic water bottles.
Plastics in the ocean can be a source of multiple problems for animals. Sometimes they don't realize that they are plastic and they'll eat them instead. And one that's really well known is sea turtles that feed on jellyfish will mistake plastic bags for jellyfish. And that's why reducing our use of plastic bags, those single-use plastic bags, is so important. New York Aquarium and Coney Island right on the beach is just such a unique experience for New Yorkers, most of whom feel that New York City is a terrestrial area and aren't really aware of that connection to the ocean that's all around us. So we hope that these sculptures help to inspire people and connect in new ways and get them thinking about the steps they can take in their life in order to become more active civically to help protect the ocean, as well as make personal decisions in order to just move forward on this journey.
The children usually just can't believe that this all came out of the ocean. And when you get that point through, yes, this is where it came from, that's very impactful.